Hello everyone, in this video we will be discussing about module 4 second chapter, that is the plasma arc machining process. So what is plasma arc machining process? That is its introduction, generation of the plasma, and the equipment and the mechanism what we are using for plasma arc machining. All these things we will be discussing in this particular video. So plasma arc machining is a material removal process as usual. But here the material removal takes place by directing a high velocity jet of high temperature, that is 11,000 to 30,000 degrees Celsius, where ionized gas on the workpiece. So what is the meaning? It is basically a thermal process by with the help of an electrical energy, where we will be creating a thermal gas. So we will just see like how to, you know, like convert the electrical energy into a thermal gas of temperature 11,000 to 30,000 degrees Celsius, and then a narrow plasma jet melts the workpiece material in its path. So with the high temperature involved, it can be used for any material, those resistance to oxy-fuel gas cutting. So what is plasma? As we are very much aware that if you take any metallic atom or non-metallic atom, it consists of protons, neutrons and electrons. But here I will be going with very selective material, in that I will be considering only a mixture of free electrons and only the positively charged ions and the neutral atoms, and these things can be separated from any atoms by various mechanisms. If you like, maybe from the for example, positively charged ions, we can able to get it only from supplying a heavy light source over any atom. Similarly, free electrons, we can able to get it from the valence bond of anything, and the neutral atoms, we can get it by removing the excess positive and negatively charged ones. So mixture of all these things we will be taking, and I'll be getting the plasma by obtaining a heat gas at high temperature, and it is partially ionized. So the central zone of plasma reaches a temperature of 15,000 degrees Celsius and it is completely ionized. Heating of gases take place in restricted region of the nozzle duct, resulting in high velocity gas exit. You can able to see this is a chamber where mixture of all these things is taking place here, where current is supplied over this. And moving to the generation of plasma, where the heating the gas to the high temperature to ionize the gas is popular method for generating plasma. So this can be done by two methods: by applying suitable electric field across the gas column, by exposing gas column to the radiation. You can able to see the temperature in the two different cases. First one is by applying the suitable electric field across the gas column. So, and different ranges they have given. So the red color indicates the temperature of 17,000 to 25,000 degree Fahrenheit, and yellow color indicates 25,000 to 32,000 degree Fahrenheit, and the pale white indicates 32,000 to 43,000 degree Fahrenheit, and pure white indicates 43,000 to 50,000 Fahrenheit. So both the cases where the two methods we can able to achieve these things. So when gases are heated, what changes may occur? So elastic and inelastic collisions between the atoms will occur. Ionization of the gases, it will take place, resulting in production of electrons and ions. And electrons collide with atoms, create high temperature and thermal kinetic energy of atoms. Further collision produce ions and electrons. So thus the new matter, which is called plasma, is characterized by its ability to conduct electricity due to the presence of free charges is produced. You can able to see here, this is a cathode block, and inside the cathode block we can able to see a electrode, where I'll be connecting a negative charge cathode to the electrode and a positively charged anodic to the workpiece, along with an anodic nozzle also it is supplied. So inside this cathodic block only, where I will be taking the mixture of the free electrons, ions, the positively charged ions and the neutrons. So all these things, with the help of this continuous power supply, I will be converting the electricity into the positive ionic gases, and even insulator is provided for to make sure that it is not getting leakaged. So what about is the process? So gases are heated and charged to your plasma state. So plasma state is nothing but the superheated and electrically ionized gas state at approximately 5000 degrees Celsius. So these gases are directly applied on the workpiece in the form of a high velocity stream, since it is coming out from the nozzle. So the gases popularly used is hydrogen, nitrogen and oxygen. So plasma arc can be used for cutting, welding and spraying, etc. So here in the one more schematic view, you can able to see like what kind of precautionary measure method we have provided to avoid the any kind of major problems. Means a proper shielding, a gas shielding nozzle is provided over this so that we can make sure that the stream of velocity of the gas is not coming out or like any leakage is not taking place. And the kind of electrode, I'm going with the tungsten electrode to make sure that it is not giving any kind of the side effects. Or maybe like shortcut circuits or like complete damage of the entire setup. And finally, since it is dealing with the high temperature conditions, so a continuous water coolant nozzle should be provided over the entire operation condition. So the plasma arc machining consists of totally four major things, that is power supply of 1000 amperes on the 200 volts direct current, and gas supply is 1.4 megapascal, cooling water system, control console and plasma torch. So power supply means here we will be using direct current power supply. So the power supply should have saturation current beyond which the current should not rise even for the short circuit. So for easy ignition and maintenance of arc, OCV must be higher than load value. So normally direct current motor generator sets are transducer control rectifier units with saturable core reactors are used. And even moving to the gas supply, so any gas that should not attack the tungsten electrode or the workpiece, the flowing pressure can be up to 1.4 megapascal, results in plasma velocity of 100 meter per second. So higher the gas flow rate, higher the momentum of the plasma jet. Higher flow rate also helps to remove the molten material from the molting zone. Carbon alloy and steel, cast steels are cut with a mixture of nitrogen and hydrogen in the compressor air. So in the steel, aluminium and other non-ferrous alloys are cut with argon, nitrogen and hydrogen gases. Gas flow rates are 2 to 11 meter cube per hour and are controlled by using mass flow controllers. And third one is nothing but the plasma torch. In plasma arc machining, electric arc consists from nozzle which generates basic plasma jet. So instead of diverging into open arc, the nozzle constricts arc into a small cross section. So the plasma arc can be classified as air plasma torch, dual gas plasma torch, that is plasma gas plus shielding gas, oxygen injector plasma torch, water injector plasma torch. And you can able to see here all the four different things we can able to see with the sketches. So this is nothing but a water tube, so plasma torch, and next one is nothing but air plasma torch, so inside the tube where air is supplied, and next one is a dual gas plasma torch where the combination of like different gases, nitrogen, oxygen, other things is there. Then water injector plasma torch is we can able to see. And what are the method to stabilize arcs? So plasma torches transforms electrical energy into thermal energy in the form of the plasma jet. It is important to stabilize the electric arc which is burns in the constricted space and forced away by gas or liquid. If liquid is used, then vapor is surrounded the arc column. So according to the stabilizing medium, there is gas or liquid stabilized plasma torches. So wall or sheet stabilization, vortex stabilization and liquid stabilization plasma torches are used. So this is for the sheet stabilized condition, and this is for the vortex, and this is for the water. You can able to see like everywhere like same setup is provided, but with the help of the sheet means like multiple layers of the gas is provided, and in case of the vortex means where it is wrapped around the electrode, and in case of the water means where in the sideways the water is supplied. And in the next video, we'll discuss more about the process parameters, the advantages, applications and the drawbacks of other things. So among all the non-traditional machining process available, the easiest one and which is not creating a much problem and even investment wise also, which is very reasonable, is nothing but plasma arc machining process. So while discussing the advantages and disadvantages, we'll discuss all this information in detail. Thank you.